didn't really understood why it is such a huge success. And so we did the Sky Movie video, which was Star Wars versus Star Trek. And with this movie, and I'm going to show it now, we had like in less than a month, 1 million clicks. So this was in this time and age a lot. And it was the beginning of user-generated content and viral marketing. This was really words I didn't knew before, but in this time and age, it was something to make money with. And so we're gonna have a look at this video. We really haven't been prepared for the success of this movie. We didn't have a concept. It was a very small budget, and I've been young and naive, and I'm still, but not young anymore, but naive. So it was a hell of a storm that came to us. So I worked by myself, I worked at home, I worked in my kitchen, I didn't have a camera of my own. I had an old computer and was VJing. I mean, I've been every week in a club doing visuals and getting a Coca-Cola and 20 euro or so. And with this video, everything changed. Like big companies like Philips and the BBC, and even Ridley Scott called me that we have to do something. And I couldn't believe what happened to me. And like, we've been a team, like, it was my girlfriend, a graffiti partner, and also a VJ friend of mine, and so we had a lot of work. So, I mean, it was 3 or 4 years we did, in this 3 or 4 years, more than 20 of those animation films for big companies, and in the beginning, for cheap money. Now I know how much you can take for it. So this was really cheap. And the other videos in the first few years was also really, really cheap. So things developed, and like, I think after this film, it only took 4 years that a company came to us and asked us to do a $2 million light painting video production. And I thought, oh yes, this sounds interesting. How to waste so much money in so short time, because I only had 3 weeks to waste 2 million euros. And yes, we finally did it. So there was the best director, Noah Harris, Glassworks. It's the company that does the Pixar animation post-production. Then was the bullet time effect from Matrix. I have to show you, it's unbelievable. The guy who does the bullet time effect for Matrix, he came with 160 video cameras to do light painting videos for us. And the guy who did the spaceship from 2001 Space Odyssey, Stanley Kubrick, he built the light sources. It's the same guy who did all the James Bond films. It's a very, very old guy. Here you can see part of the 160 cameras, and every 20 cameras we need a computer. And yes, it looks like England, but it's South Africa. Because it was, they want to shoot during the summertime. The night was too short. I explained them how many nights we will need, and they said, we have to find a solution. I said, yes, make the night longer. And they find a solution. Yes, we fly to Africa, and we build a street that just looks like England. That's the solution. Yes, I thought, wow, good plan. Then there was like this cubes out of neon light. We had hundreds of them to do animation. Here you see the rig. These are light sources we developed. These are splash animations. It was a twisting light. So every light source in this video has been designed by us and built by this guy from London. I only did the prototypes. Later on, you see my prototype. It looks like bullshit, but he did a good job. So this is like a design of a flower. Here's one of the light sources. So it's like spinning light around a bunch of lights. And of course, really, really interesting stuff that we did. Oh yeah, here on this screen. So I got like designs I did with Illustrator of how the light should look and how the texture should be. Then I did a small painting of how it could work. Then I did a prototype, and then at the end we did the video. So this was my prototype. It's only scotch tape and a bunch of lights. So, here you see the 160 cameras again. This was quite amazing. Here we had like, if you screw a hole into a wall, you have this neat machines, and we put a light wire on this to make the balloons. Here the same, but in big size. It's worth a spinning light wire. This is 6 meter high trees, and there is like an LED stripe rotating around this tree, and it was on a grass field, and the rotation was one rotation per second. It just felt like a helicopter if you go this big scale. So it was amazing. So these are some light sources. The tree with the rotation. This was for a rainbow effect that we're gonna see later. Here are the rainbows in a test. The trees in action. So we're gonna have a look at this video, which is really fun. Action.
The city lights, the pretty lights, they can warm the coldest nights. All the people going places, smiling with electric faces. Life is loud.
Join TalkTalk, Britain's brighter phone and broadband company.
I show you some short. It was for the X Factor in England. They did it. That was one of the reasons. Okay, I do it full screen. Wo war's nochmal hier?
Life is loud.
Talk Talk Phone and Broadband, brightening your X Factor. We love bright ideas. Talk Talk Phone and Broadband sponsors the X Factor. Will your favourite act take off? Talk Talk Phone and Broadband sponsors the X Factor. Chat to friends everywhere about the X Factor. Talk Talk sponsors the X Factor. Love gossiping about the show? Talk Talk sponsors the X Factor. Chat to your friends about the show. Talk Talk Phone and Broadband sponsors the X Factor.
That's actually where we come from. So we did this animation movies and we had like more and more success and more budgets, and we had to get a company doing professional photography and animation movies by using light as the message, actually. Yes, everything we do it with light. So I show you some of the photo stuff we did. Like, I really do it fast, because it's like most of it is advertisement. So I had really, with this first Sky Movies film, a chance, once in a lifetime chance. So I can choose using this success to be an artist, because I had like a big audience and there has been a lot of people interested in our work, or use it in a commercial way. So I tried a mixture, but there are forces, and if you are a company with a lot of people and you have to do it like in a commercial way, it was always going to a commercial way. So at the end, I love to go outside with my friends and do some nice pictures and try to really explore it. But how it works now, it's like we are really happy with what we are doing. We are working a great team, but we always have to fulfill a mission, and the mission is making a client happy. So we did, this is done with hundreds of elements. Maybe this is only 20 in this picture, but we did hundreds of elements and photoshopped those light painting elements to this light illuminated woman. It was a series for a fashion fair. It's a quite old series, 8 years I think these pictures are old. So we did first a sketch on paper, then we did the single elements, and then we produced them together. And this is a free work we do. This is something for, how these things are called, to make the water a tap. Yes, it's a water tap, and a kitchen chef, which is quite famous. So it's the movement of his work in a kitchen. These are condoms, energy condoms. This was for Speedo for the Olympic Games. It was like the 80 years of Speedo, a graffiti magazine, Desperados, alcoholic drinks. Yeah, some free work, again, Desperados. This was for Next, which is ESPN sports magazine from the States. They had the logo and they asked us how to do it in light, so I did a mood board, very rough, to show them how many ways we have to do to make them a light design logo. I think it was the red one, the second from the top. Here you can see one of the first works. We did it for Philips, our first Aurea TV. It was a TV that has some light in the background, so the quality of the light and the contrast was very important for Philips. So we developed special things that we attached to our light source to get this rich textures. But I'm sorry, I won't explain how we did it, because this is a secret concept. Dinosaurs and monsters. So this is more or less the photography stuff. So it's, you see, it's a mixture of like free work and the commercial stuff. So, and in the Talk Talk video at the beginning, you saw someone painting with light in real time. So this was not a computer effect. We really developed a software that can do it. And in this event here, you saw it like at the beginning event and yesterday on the party. So for those of you who haven't joined us on this nice party, I'm gonna show this video again where we use it. So maybe, because it's actually done for performers, so I show you the showreel. In clubs, we do it in events, we do it everywhere and worldwide. So, and we also could do it like really big scale. So, and these are performances that are really huge. So we've got a stage on a boat and we project on huge size here. This is a museum, and we did like with exponats from the museum, like shells and stuff, and some dinosaurs bones, and so we did the big hall from the museum. We did as collage in during an event. So this is like also something you could do with it. Maybe I show you this here. It's like a party. We'll be right back. I'll show you two more of those performances to give you a really better understanding how those things develop. Because everything, so we started coming from light painting, then we did like this show software. At the beginning we did the shows ourselves, then we found professional dancers and crews that has been very interested to work with us together. And now we do the show concepts and work for those big clients and develop these shows. And but everything is developing. So this is a show that is still has to do with the light and but it's not a light painting show anymore. So but coming from light painting, you can see where we going through. So it's like it still has to do with light, but it's not light painting. So it's this here. With the coder, we also developed a software that we can do light painting with a finger on an iPad. So therefore, we did like pictures from our light sources, from all the angles, like all angle there is, with a camera, and designed brushes to do light painting on an iPad. So therefore we thought it's interesting. We had like a lot of critics, people that told us, oh no, you should not do it, but you want to see it or not, so okay, cool. So but don't blame us. It was, everyone has to do an app for an iPad, so and what to do, so. It's a cool app, makes a lot of fun, and if you want to do a design and send it to a client and you don't have the time and you only have a picture, you can use this software. Actually, it's for free now, and if you only want to do a random design, it's a powerful tool. Thank you.